Welcome to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan, where we're going to cast and blast you right out of this world with some of the best hunting and fishing stories that you can't even imagine.
Hi, this is John Hennigan on Fish Hunt Talk, and we're certainly glad to have you guys tuning in. We've got some very interesting people. I want to find out what's happening in Cabo San Lucas, which I think people are going to find interesting. And then we got some great information on fishing line. I mean, what do you do without a hook and line? You ain't fishing, are you? Anyway, it's all going to be exciting stuff. And I want to mention that we do still have right now availability to go up to Ketchikan. That'll be September, what is it, the 9th through the 13th. So check back with us. Go to the website. Fishradio.com is real simple. Just go to that and check us out. And any place, any of you guys want to know, if we can't take you, we can set you up. So just please stay in touch. And then also we started a few weeks ago with a giveaway. So you just send an email to, right now it's easier just to send it to John at fishtalkradio.com. And we'd like to find out who's out there, what part of the world they're in. So just send an email and we'll make it worth your while. I've been in the hospital for a while, so I'm behind on getting my stuff out. But we've got plenty of things in the treasure chest. So just get in touch with us is the most important thing. And we appreciate everybody out there doing that, trying to figure out how many people and where they are. We got a lot of people, and we're finding out that they're coming from some surprising places. Ukraine and Great Britain, but mostly, of course, from the U.S.
Pretty much all over the world. John, let's go ahead and take our first break. We're going to be coming back with Bob McCray out of Klamath, California, and we're still trying to get Frank Selby on the line. So this is Fish Hunt Talk Radio. We'll be right back.
A few years ago, a sailor set out to design a boat shoe that was comfortable and stable, non-skid, and wouldn't mark the decks. Today, these incredibly comfortable shoes are worn by anglers, boaters, professional guides, and charter captains. Go to softscience.com to see more. Soft Science shoes and boots are lightweight and shock absorbent with just the right level of support. Several styles come in all sizes. Enjoy the Soft Science shoe in the water and out. Check them out at softscience.com.
It's time for you to take a real fun adventure. Join a hosted fishing adventure to Alaska or Baja with the staff of Fish Talk Radio. Real Fun Adventures can book you on any adventure you desire. Bring your fishing friends or meet new ones. Fish Talk Radio gets the best deals from our sponsors to give you the best possible price. Real Fun Trips are inclusive, easy, no-worry packages to the most popular fish grounds. Trips start around $600. Go to REEL funadventures.com.
If you are still using a plastic hard shell cooler, things have changed for the better. AO coolers are lighter with twice the efficiency of the traditional bulky coolers. AO coolers are the best available soft-sided cooler with 3/4-inch high-density closed cell foam insulation. They will keep ice frozen for 24 hours in hot weather. Easy to carry, less space, it fits product inside for better performance. Go to AOCoolers.com to order or find a retailer. Available at West Marine.
We have something new and exciting for all fishermen and fisherwomen, from 5 to 12-year-old boys and girls to teenagers and adults. Join the Unreal Fish Tales Fresh and Saltwater Fishing Club to get an amazing 50% discount on all Unreal rods and reels, 40% discount on all apparel, and 30% discount on all Unreal mounts. This monthly Fresh and Saltwater video contest has a cash prize up to $2,500. Members who join our Unreal Fish Tales Club anytime this current holiday season will receive a free Unreal Fishtails shirt or hat of their choice. Go to our website at unrealfishtails.com to join. It's unreal.
Fish have tails. Do you have an Unreal Fishtail to share? Unreal Fishtails wants to post it. Go to unrealfishtails.com. Real is spelled with a double E. Join the club and win big money with your short videos. No matter what, you win with half price on all quality reels and rods. Plus, huge discounts and accessories. Perfect gift for anglers. Check out the website now at unrealfishtails.com.
Catch them shallow, I can catch them deep. Open water or the back of the creek. The wind and rain to me, it's all the same. I make a living from playing this game. And I thank the Lord above every time I can. I get to be a fisherman.
Welcome back to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan.
John, are you there?
This is John Hennigan, and we've got our host, Frank Selby, who is going to start things off with us.
So
let's get Frank to jump in and introduce his guest.
Okay. We have Bob. He's a really good friend. He's a guide up north, and he does kayak trips on two different rivers and sometimes in the bay. Bob, are you there?
Hey, Frank,
yes,
I'm
Frank.
Sorry, but you could be anywhere in the world. So up north doesn't mean anything. In the bay means nothing either.
I'll tell you where I'm at. I'm in Klamath, California, which is 50 miles south the Oregon border on the Klamath River. And I'm in the middle of the redwoods, absolutely beautiful, gorgeous. Temperatures are averaging right now about 62 to 64, and that is just beautiful. But the fishing, let's talk about that. There's a lot of salmon out in the ocean. They're having a hard time coming up. The reason for that is the ocean's running about 50 degrees, and when those fish hit that mouth of that river and it's 72, it's a shock. So they're coming in and going out, coming in and going out. And I believe when they travel at night when it's a little cooler. But people are catching fish. Come on up. Company is Rogue Outdoor Sports. I'm located at Camper Corral in Klamath, California.
Now, are these Chinooks, or what are they?
The Chinooks, yes.
Mm-hmm.
We're the 15th of next month. We get what they call the fall season. Right now we're fishing for the springers, which are a little smaller fish, but they're a better eating fish. They're a redder meat. Just absolutely delicious. Put them on the barbie, a little salt and pepper, and that's all you need.
That's all I need.
The fall fish are a bigger fish, and I believe they're out there eating. If you look at them, the meat is red pinkish, so they're probably eating a lot of shrimp and that type of predation.
Mm-hmm.
But it's tough fishing. That's what fishing's all about.
Yeah.
A good fisherman catches fish. I'll put it that way. Frank.
Hey, Bob, how many do you take down a river with your kayaks?
I take 10. I take up to 10.
Yeah, I'm on my way up this coming week. We'll go out and fish one of your slow days. How's that sound?
That sounds absolutely great, Frank. I'd look forward to it.
Yeah, what is it, about a 10-hour drive from here?
If you leave 5 in the morning, you're going to be in Redding at 4 o'clock, and then it's 3 hours across. So it's about an 11-hour drive.
Yeah. It's worth that to see you and give you a bad time on the river.
yeah, you're right.
So you've been pretty booked, or you still got a few openings for our listeners?
Well, I've got openings. We kind of, because of this virus thing that's going around, it's been a little different, but we'll get spurts. Like the 4th of July here at the park, I don't know if I should say this over the phone or not, over the radio, but we had 900 people here. And it was great. Everybody had a great time. There wasn't any issues. Last weekend, we had about 500. Looking at the tally today, we're probably going to have 400 to 500 today, this weekend. Everybody's coming from the Redding area or Central California because of the heat. And like I say, we're at 62 to 64 degrees and nice little breeze. It's beautiful. The river's gorgeous. If you just take a trip down, float down, it's, you know, it's, you're in awe. You see otters, osprey, bald eagles. Once in a while, you see a bear, deer, of course. But we've got a lot of wild animals up here. At the park, actually, the bears come in at night.
Well, I think the biggest wild animal is in the lead kayak.
Well, last time we were on the call, I was in the ocean, and we were doing nothing but catching fish. I mean, I can't remember if you remember or not, but it was like every time I was talking to you, it was, oh, he's hooked up again. Hang on. Bottom fishing in the out of Crescent City, California, is absolutely great.
Well, you do about 80% of the time you're doing that, so none of us have a 100% rate, but you're one of the highest guys getting your clients into fish.
Oh, I got them on fish. There's no question about it.
Yeah.
And I get them hooked up, too.
You get them hooked up, but you don't guarantee them to land them, right?
That's it. That's their choice.
Hey, Mark, you got any questions for Bob?
Well, tell us about Rogue Outdoor Sports, Bob. Do you rent kayaks? How does it all work?
Well, I've got a rental fleet here. I also have a sporting goods store.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't think I told you that before, but there's a sporting goods store here. It's Rogue Outdoor Sports, and in conjunction with that is the kayak rentals. So they rent them for just taking nice trips down the river.
Mm-hmm.
Or I'll take them guiding fishing. And I get 10 people, and they're just wanting to take a beautiful trip. And if you look at my Facebook page, you'll see a lot of pictures. And that's, again, Rogue Outdoor Sports.
So that's rogueoutdoorsports.com. They can check it out on the Internet.
Correct.
Okay. And do you rent equipment, too? Do they need to bring their own fishing gear?
It depends. I rent... Primarily what I'm renting is for perch fishing, because perch fishing up here is absolutely spectacular.
Oh.
We catch what they call a red-tailed perch, and the minimum size is 10 and a half inches. We've had them up to 3 pounds this year. It's a nice-sized fish, good fillets, and good eating.
And what about those stand-up paddle boards? Do you guys have those, too?
I have those also.
All right.
That's starting to come on a little bit in the beginning. I got them last year and didn't have too much success. But as the paddleboard industry is growing, people are coming and they're asking for the stand-up board. So that's a good thing. It's a good thing to have something here for people to do, because it just isn't a lot.
Yeah, yeah. And are you still a fly casting instructor? You still do that kind of stuff?
Absolutely.
All right.
If he didn't, I would have shot him. Bob and me go back a lot of years. He always does the kayaks at the Fred Hall Show. I do a couple of programs. And we've been friends since the first day we met.
We have. That's quite a few years now.
Yeah, well, just don't mention the years to start to bother me. Well, the other thing I wanted to get to let people know is you will also guide them down the river if a bunch want to go down, and you'll kayak them down and guide them just like you were guiding them if you were fishing.
This is correct. I limit myself to the number of people I take down because there's so much traffic on the river with boats. I want to make sure everybody is safe.
Oh, Bob, and, tell us about the kayaks.
Well, they're all Hobie kayaks, and which is, in my opinion, the top of the line. I've got a nice fleet. I've got I fish when I'm doing the guiding. I fish out of the inflatable ones, which have a seat, pedal system, and your hands-free fishing. They're absolutely great.
Guys, I'm so sorry. I got to bust in here. We got a commercial break we've got to take. That was Bob McCray, Klamath, California, Rogue Outdoor Sports. Check it out. We'll be right back on Fish Hunt Talk Radio.
Something new and exciting for all fishermen and fisherwomen, from 5 to 12 year old boys and girls to teenagers and adults. Join the Unreal Fish Tales Fresh and Saltwater Fishing Club to get an amazing 50% discount on all Unreal rods and reels, 40% discount on all apparel, and 30% discount on all Unreal mounts. This monthly Fresh and Saltwater video contest has a cash prize up to $2,500. Members who join our Unreal Fish Tales Club anytime this holiday season will receive a free Unreal Fish Tales shirt or hat of their choice. Go to our website at unrealfishtales.com to join. It's unreal.
Fish have tails. Do you have an unreal fish tail to share? Unreal Fish Tales wants to post it. Go to unrealfishtales.com. Real is spelled with a double E. Join the club and win big money with your short videos. No matter what, you win with half price on all quality reels and rods. Plus, huge discounts and accessories. Perfect gift for anglers. Check out the website now at unrealfishtales.com.
Fish on!
That's a big one.
For passionate sports fishermen who value first-class fishing experiences paired with personalized service and amenities, all-inclusive Salmon Falls Fishing Resort on the Inland Passage reinvents the Ketchikan fishing getaway. Guests enjoy exceptional gourmet cuisine, superior fishing excursions, fully guided charter or self-guided in center console boats accommodating three anglers, updated guest rooms and suites, on-site fishing processing to clean, freeze, and pack your catch. Rooms range from log cabin rustic to modern. Our 52 rooms offer the ultimate in comfort after a long day of sightseeing, fishing, and exploring Ketchikan. Non-anglers love Salmon Falls, too. Shopping along Creek Street, kayaking, hiking, whale watching, or gathering around our fire pits with a hot beverage, all at prices less than expected. Just pull up Salmon Falls Resort in your search engine.
The East Cape of Baja, Mexico is world famous for sport fishing. Dorado, tuna, wahoo, marlin, sailfish, roosterfish, and pargo. The Van Wormer Resorts make dreams come true at a price all can afford. Hotel Palmas de Cortez, Playa del Sol, and Hotel Punta Colorado have the biggest and best sport fishing fleet in all of Mexico. Call toll-free to 877-777-TUNA to find out how affordable world-class fishing can be. The finest resorts and the best boats in East Cape. Call 877-777-TUNA.
Vagabundos Del Mar Boat and Travel Club has 42 years experience introducing RVers to the joys of Mexico. Specializing in Baja, Vagabundos leads caravans and sponsors fishing tournaments, trailer boat cruises, and weekend getaways in Mexico and the West. Vagabundos Del Mar also saves its 10,000 members tons of money on low-cost auto insurance. Stay up to date on Mexican travel with the printed newsletter online at vagabundos.com or call 800-474-BAJA.
Welcome back to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan.
This is John Hennigan, and of course we have our host, Frank Selby, of course, is in here with us. And we have somebody that we've had on before, but you never have enough of. You know, there are certain basics when it comes to fishing. And, you know, if you don't have those, then you're sitting on the couch watching TV. But obviously you need a hook and line if you want to go fishing. And Joe is an expert with Berkley on fishing line. And Joe, you've got a couple new ones that we want to hear about and maybe some tips online. So why don't, instead of me talking. Let's just let you.
All right. And thanks, John and Frank, for having me on. You know, it's just, for us, if I'm in Iowa, it's a great day in Iowa, about 85 degrees. We're loving it. Anyhow, yeah. We had a ICAST this past July, and everybody knows that everything lately has been virtual, so ICAST has been a virtual event as well. And just so you know, we had one of our products won the best category for the fishing line category for best product for 2020, and that's our Berkley Floral Shield, which you're going to find out it'll be in the market come October, like mid-October. And people are asking, so what's Floral Shield? Why did you come out with it? What's the reasoning behind it? And well, us guys out here in the middle of the Cornfield County, Iowa, we love. What's this?
It's okay, Joe. I think John's talking to some people at the hospital there.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, and we love, obviously we love to do a lot of playing with fishing line, and so what we've created is, it's kind of the best of both worlds. It's a copolymer, and what we've done is we've basically built in the fluorocarbon into the product that gives you a... It has the near invisibility and the abrasion resistance as what you get with a fluorocarbon, but yet
Joe, can you do me a favor, since there's not too many chemists that listen to this?
Yeah.
And when you start throwing things like copolymer and mono and these different things, can you get a little bit of an explanation of what all that means? I know that mono used to be nothing but nylon, and I guess it's still got nylon in it, but can you kind of explain what goes into fishing line?
Absolutely. When you get copolymers or tripolymers, we're adding additives all the time to our line to get it to give you different benefits and features. And so there's a few other products out there like this that are fluoropolymer treated.
Could you keep it down?
Okay, so we built our material. We blended it right in. So we give this product that gives that permanent kind of a fluorocarbon, almost near invisibility underwater and abrasion resistant while remaining manageable like a traditional nylon monofilament or a monofilament that everybody knows.
Right.
So
give
we
a
built
little
in the
give
best
stretch.
Of all worlds into this product. Absolutely. And so it comes in... it comes in 10 different sizes, all the way from 4 pound up to 30 pound. And you can get it in a 300 yard filler spool, or for the offshore, the bigger guys, you can get it in a 3,000 yard bulk put up. But it's the best of both worlds when you add that copolymer core that built into that fluoropolymer. And that's what's the beauty of a fluoropolymer, which is fluorocarbon. Because everybody's talking about fluorocarbon and the near invisibility to a fish. I can get into a lot more science, but we'll leave it at that. So anyhow, it's pretty cool for us that we won Best of Category at ICAST in 2020.
Boy,
and so
that's
the
good.
Other new product that we came out with, obviously in California, most of you aren't going to ever use it, but we make Fireline. We make Fireline Ultra 8. And in our Ultra 8 series, we came out with a 1 pound size, which is really, really small. And we'll have it in our ice fishing market. So for us in the middle, upper Midwest, love ice fishing. You've got this zero stretch, virtually clear 1 pound strand of line that just a little bit larger than the size of your hair, but is really strong, really, really, really strong.
The size
Which
of your hair?
Cool.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah. Yep. So you
hey, Joe, is there a formula for the strength of the line and the size of the fish? I mean, you can catch, especially Frank on his fly line, you know, catch a 60, 80-pound fish on 20-pound test. But is there any kind of guidelines that you use?
You've asked a good question. A lot of it comes into just not strictly the line. It has to do with the combination of the reel and the rod you're using.
All right.
If you have a flexible, the reason why that works on a fly fishing application, as Frank would have there, most of your fly rods have a lot of give to them. And that give will allow that line to be able to hold up at a much lower pound test than if you had a fishing rod that was really, really stiff. If you have a really stiff rod, something has to give in the system, and then the only thing giving in the system is your fishing line. So that's how that all comes together there. So for us, most of our ice fishing rods have a lot more flex to them.
Oh.
And again, a one-pound line like that, you know, you're going to get somewhere in the range of about a 4 or 5 pound break strength. You know, I've had people pull in 2, 3, 4 pound pike on the darn stuff. And so pike, northern pike fish, you know, bite pretty hard. And most people are going to
Fire line's been around for a while. Can you give them more explanation about what it is?
Fire line is actually, it's a whole different process. It's a patented process that we developed back in the mid-90s. And we take all that nice, again, I'll get into a chemical term or a technical term, the base fiber is gel-spun polyethylene, same stuff your bulletproof vests are made out of, and we take all them little weaves, like in a typical braid you have, you can feel all the little weaves.
Right.
We produce it so that becomes one. We have a patented process that makes that.
So it's going to compress the line in together to make it a solid line.
Absolutely. And by doing that, you actually increase your abrasion resistance a ton, and you give a line a totally different feel to it. And so we.
And would you use that instead of mono or fluorocarbon or in addition to or what?
You can. It's very big in the upper Midwest for all our typical walleye fishermen. A lot of the pan fishermen use it on a spinning reel. It has maybe a little more body than a traditional soft, supple, loose braid. But it has amazing abrasion resistance. And because it has what I would say is a touch of body, you don't typically get near the wind knots with it because
right.
Maintains its shape and structure a little bit better.
Hey, Joe, this is Mark back here in the studio. Before we run out of time, tell us about knots, how we get knots, and what the heck to do about them.
Oh, well, perfect segue into that. that's awesome. You know, a lot of people struggle with wind knots. And, in fact, everybody struggles with wind knots, especially on super lines and a spinning reel. And I get beat up all the time because, hey, your line is bad, or I'm sure other companies' line people say, you know, your line. And a lot of it has to do with the spinning reel and then how your line goes on that spinning reel. If you're normally casting your spinning line out, the best thing that you can do is tighten your line up slightly as you clip your bail over so there's no loose loops. And the only reason I'm watching doing this is I've done a lot of fishing, and I'm watching my line and trying to figure out where that's coming from. If you have loose line underneath, and now you've got tight line over top, that loose loop can come off maybe 2 or 3 loops early where it shouldn't have come off, and then it ties itself in a knot. The other thing is if you watch close, you make sure your reel puts the line on very evenly from top to bottom. If you have a reel that ends up being shifting your line more to the top and a gap on the bottom, or more on the bottom and a gap on the top, when you're casting, what will happen is an extra loop will slough off from the large diameter down to the smaller diameter, and then that underneath loop will go on out with the top line, and when it does that, that creates a knot in your line. And it's a real pain in the behind. I'm sure you've seen it. I've seen it. And you're like, so the main thing there is make sure your line is on your reel very evenly from top to bottom. And then number two, when your bail is clipped over, make sure your line is tight so you don't have a loose loop or two underneath. It's those loose loops underneath that typically cause all the issues.
What do you think, Frank? That makes sense, Frank?
It makes a lot of sense,
yeah.
And I agree 110%.
Me too.
Because I don't care, even with the fly line, if you don't keep it tight when you're putting it back on the reel and watching it, you can get a backlash.
Have you ever tried when you get line that's, you know, wants to be a plate of spaghetti, just drop the whole thing in the water and then kind of let it unwind itself?
undo itself?
That will help as well. Absolutely. Yep. No, you're on it. I've watched it. I've seen it happen. And now I typically don't have near the wind knots as other people because I watch that all the time. In my case, I actually pull my rod tip up, and then I clip my bail so I know my line is tight.
Oh, I see.
Nothing like a good tight line, that's for sure. Joe, thank you for being on the show, buddy. We appreciate it. Go to berkley-fishing.com, and we've got more show coming up here on Fish Hunt Talk Radio. Coming back with Jim Korchinski from Cabo. That's what John wanted to talk about, and we'll be right back.
Listen how it's called to me. Lessons that I should be. I am fishing. Yeah. Come on, fishing. Yeah, yeah. Come on, fishing.
The road stretches for miles in front of you. And with the Ram 1500, you'll be able to reach mile after open mile. It gets a best-in-class 25 miles per gallon highway, so your destination won't just be determined by your gas gauge, but by your gauge for achievement. And the Ram 1500 is the first-ever back-to-back Motor Trend Truck of the Year. Guts. Glory. Ram. See your local Ram dealer today for great deals. EPA estimated 25 mpg highway based on V6 4x2.
A full-service fly shop, His and Her Fly Fishing, offers FFI-certified international fly fishing instructor and guide service with Frank Selby. Listen to Frank as host of FishHuntTalkRadio.com or listen live Saturdays at 9 a.m. Pacific Time on Sirius XM Radio Channel 211. Custom flies are handmade to your order in-house in Newport Beach. Fishing in Mexico, Belize, Florida, or the Rockies, Frank and the staff will deliver exactly what you need. Flies and gear. Google His and Her Fly Fishing.
Alaskan RV Butler. Guiding, fishing, hiking, sightseeing, adventure. The Alaskan RV Butler. Like a cruise on wheels in the comfort of an RV, view the wonders of Alaskan interior streams, ocean, and wildlife. Or fish for the big one, all while pampered by Mike, the Alaskan RV Butler. Mike's inclusive tours serve butter-drenched shellfish and mouth-watering steaks. Mike is your personal chef, chauffeur, guide, and planner. And for the real Alaska, contact MikeRVButler at gmail.com. That's MikeRVButler at gmail.com.
We have something new and exciting for all fishermen and fisherwomen, from 5 to 12-year-old boys and girls to teenagers and adults. Join the Unreal Fish Tales Fresh and Saltwater Fishing Club to get an amazing 50% discount on all Unreal rods and reels, 40% discount on all apparel, and 30% discount on all Unreal mounts. This monthly Fresh and Saltwater video contest has a cash prize up to $2,500. Members who join our Unreal Fish Tales Club anytime this holiday season will receive a free Unreal Fishtails shirt or hat of their choice. Go to our website at unrealfishtails.com to join. It's unreal.
Fish have tails. Do you have an Unreal Fishtail to share? Unreal Fishtails wants to post it. Go to unrealfishtails.com. Real is spelled with a double E. Join the club and win big money with your short videos. No matter what, you win with half price on all quality reels and rods, plus huge discounts and accessories. Perfect gift for anglers. Check out the website now at unrealfishtails.com.
It's time for you to take a real fun adventure. Join a hosted fishing adventure to Alaska or Baja with the staff of Fish Talk Radio. Real Fun Adventures can book you on any adventure you desire. Bring your fishing friends or meet new ones. Fish Talk Radio gets the best deals from our sponsors to give you the best possible price. Real Fun Trips are inclusive, easy, no-worry packages to the most popular fish grounds. Trips start around $600. Go to reelfunadventures.com.
Welcome back to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan.
This is John Hennigan, and of course we have our host, Frank Selby. And on the line with us, we have Jim Korchinski, who's also a friend. We've had him on more than a couple of times. He actually lives in Canada, but part-time in Cabo San Lucas, where he's got a fleet of boats. And his... I wouldn't call them boats, they're yachts. Give us just a real quick rundown of your fleet, Jim.
Hi, John. Hi, Frank.
Hi.
We've got four incredible yachts, 32-foot lures, a 43 Riviera, 35 Riviera, and a 60-foot Bertram.
Wow.
And, as you know, you've been on the boats, John. We've got our English-speaking crew, and I'm using Rip and Who and Squid Nation teasers, and I've painted the bottom of my boat with bait balls to give our customers every advantage.
Well, you do well. And also, just as far as tours, where do you rank in Cabo San Lucas as far as clientele for touring and fishing?
Can you say that again, John?
Yeah, where is your website? Where do you find you?
No, that's not the question. Is it TripAdvisor, I believe? They have a ranking for people that have been on trips.
We've got over 4,100 excellent reviews. Why don't we talk about what's going on in Cabo right now due to this special time?
Yes, let's do that.
Because of the quarantine in the spring, they shut the marina down. No boats were allowed to go out. It was really hard on the community. And I'm not sure if you saw the video where all the Jack Crevels came into the marina, and there was this tidal wave of Jack Crevels causing whirlpool-type action in the marina. They actually came into the marina.
That
was kind of crazy. So we've been operating for about 2 weeks now with a limited fleet. We've got our 32 and our 60 in the water. And we're happy to welcome Americans. I looked on a website, and there's, I'm not sure the other country, but Americans only have Mexico as an option to go on vacation.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. It's not the only place they can go, but it's makes the most sense.
So we've seen a strong influx of tourism, and because there was no pressure on the marlin and all that, we've been going out, and we actually caught a baby blue, 300 pounds, 2 days ago, which is quite rare in July and August.
I wouldn't call that a baby, but yeah.
Yeah, I do. And as you know, John, I'm very protective of our fish. We release our marlin, and we keep our tuna and dorado.
Right. And has there been any dorado?
A little bit. But ironically, we caught a 50-pound wahoo 2 days ago as well.
Oh, those are really awesome. Wahoo means good eating.
Yeah, they call that the filet mignon of the sea.
Yeah. That's awesome. And not only that, they're fun to catch. They're not the fastest fish in the ocean, but they're very fast. Actually, you know what the fastest fish is? The
With
second
that,
one
John?
Is the blue marlin.
Yeah.
The first one is black marlin.
I've been really excited.
And then the sailfish.
Yeah.
And so strong.
Since we've been down, we've been using the Squid Nation and Rip and Hew teasers, which I just love because it's like pulling a disco show behind the boat.
Yeah.
And everything lights up.
Yeah. But, you get a marlin. They don't run forever, but, black will get up to 80 miles an hour. And a blue will be, can run over 70. Can you imagine being tied up to something like that?
I think a few times you can.
Well, you better be careful with your thumb. But that's why they're so exciting. And he's coming, jumping out of the water, flying out of the water. Pretty exciting stuff. And when they don't get fish for 3 or 4 months, you mentioned yourself that you think that Cabo, probably one of the best fishing grounds in the world under normal circumstance.
Yeah, under normal. So right now... and we just had a family went out this morning, and they did a bunch of bottom fishing.
I'm sorry, can you speak louder?
We had a family go out with some children, so you've always got options to do some bottom fishing as well.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, I guess Sierras and inshore stuff. But, you get out there.
July and August, we've got the roosters as well, which is exciting. Well,
yeah.
Now you're talking my fun.
Well, you probably, you put your line in the water, you don't know what you're going to get, but you're probably going to get something good.
So, Frank, I've got a some Canadian rods, like they're spinners or like a mooching rod.
Yeah.
They're probably, what, about, 8 feet tall. And they just bend like crazy. And I use that for my roosters down there. It's just so much fun because it's a one-to-one free spool reel. And
oh, really?
So it's, and we call them up in Canada knuckle busters.
Yes.
Yeah.
I've got one of them.
Be similar to a fly rod.
Yeah.
And I have used one of them on a fly rod.
Yeah. So typically up here in Canada, we'll use them for salmon.
One of my buddies gave me that up in Canada. And it looks like it's about 5 inches and pretty wide, about 2 inches, and it'll hold a lot of line.
You bet. Yeah.
And I have hit my some more than once, thinking I could palm it. You can't.
But just make sure you get your gloves on.
Yeah, well, don't take this the wrong way, but the old guys like them knuckle busters better. I think they believe it gives them a lot better fight for both sides. And it's a hell of a lot of fun, I'll tell you that.
Yeah.
If you don't hurt yourself too many times.
Right. Right.
Have you done that a couple times, Jim?
He's at a school of Jack Crevalle. Now, those, they're not really a game fish for eating. You can. But they're strong. That's what they call them, the turtle, right?
Yeah.
It's like, they fight like a bull. They're very, very durable. And you get into a school of those, man, you'd be busy for a while.
So just to give you some geography, we're really spoiled in Cabo. And if you know, John, of course, the lighthouse area has always got bait fish, and that's always good to chase the marlin.
Right.
And bait cast. Our crew will bait cast at the front of the boat.
I'm sorry, repeat that and speak up.
So instead of trolling for the marlin, our staff will sight the marlin and then bait cast from the front of the boat.
Oh. That makes for a good hookup. Hooking up to a marlin is fun anyway. But when you set the hook yourself, That's completely different.
Yeah. That's great. Well, thanks for giving me the phone call and the opportunity. If anybody wants to visit our website, it's www.blueskycabo.com.
One more time, Jim.
blueskycabo.com,
yeah.
Okay, blueskycabo.com. Is that correct?
That's right. And if anybody wants to send me an email and mention Fish Talk Radio, we'll give them an extra charter to go float and spend another day.
Well, I was just going to say that the fishing would be great, but just those boats that you've got, that's full-on luxury. Just to cruise around or just float around for an hour or two.
Hey, Jim, offering?
You go downstairs and lay in the bunk, and then when they hook up, and you say, how big is it? And they say 300 pounds. You say, oh, my back's hurting. Let somebody else take it.
I go downstairs, and the girl comes down and tinkles her bell. He says, Mr. Hennigan, you have a fish on.
Oh, my God.
And, And I go, yeah, what is it? How big is it?
Oh, my God.
No, I'll give it to Frank.
Hey, Jim, are you still offering the sunset cruises?
Not at this time because of COVID.
The COVID,
we'll
yeah.
We'll resume them in October, November when the government allows us to do that.
Okay, all right. Jim Kwiecinski calling in from Canada. We're talking about Cabo and the incredible website, Cabo Fishing Charters, Blue Sky Cabo. It's all right there. We're going to come back after a quick break here on Fish Hunt Talk Radio. Be sure and check out the website, fishhunttalkradio.com. We'll be right back.
We have something new and exciting for all fishermen and fisherwomen, from 5 to 12-year-old boys and girls to teenagers and adults. Join the Unreal Fish Tales Fresh and Saltwater Fishing Club to get an amazing 50% discount on all Unreal rods and reels, 40% discount on all apparel, and 30% discount on all Unreal mounts. This monthly Fresh and Saltwater video contest has a cash prize up to $2,500. Members who join our Unreal Fish Tales Club anytime this holiday season will receive a free Unreal Fishtails shirt or hat of their choice. Go to our website at unrealfishtails.com to join. It's unreal.
Fish have tails. Do you have an unreal fishtail to share? Unreal Fishtails wants to post it. Go to unrealfishtails.com. Real is spelled with a double E. Join the club and win big money with your short videos. No matter what, you win with half price on all quality reels and rods. Plus, huge discounts and accessories. Perfect gift for anglers. Check out the website now at unrealfishtails.com.
The Soft Science footbed absorbs the shock of pounding waves, engine vibration, and even rocky terrain. Soft Science shoes are roomy and relaxed, and they drain and dry quickly. Check out the Soft Science Fin fishing shoes and boots and the Fin H2O for kayaking and canoeing. They're lightweight, slip resistant, and won't mark your deck. See the new styles for men and women and get your pair on at softscience.com. Used by fishermen who know where to get the best fishing gear around, AFTCO makes the highest quality fishing rod components worldwide. If it says AFTCO, you know you have a quality rod. Guy Harvey Clothing, the best outdoor clothing line anywhere, is also available through AFTCO. Longest lasting, functional, and best looking clothing you'll be proud to wear. Only the very best materials and workmanship. As soon as you put it on, you'll know the difference. Look for AFTCO at quality retailers or go to AFTCO.com.
Fish on!
It's a big one.
For passionate sports fishermen who value first-class fishing experiences paired with personalized service and amenities, all-inclusive Salmon Falls Fishing Resort on the Inland Passage reinvents the Ketchikan fishing getaway. Guests enjoy exceptional gourmet cuisine, superior fishing excursions, fully guided charter or self-guided in center console boats accommodating three anglers, updated guest rooms and suites, on-site fishing processing to clean, freeze, and pack your catch. Rooms range from log cabin rustic to modern. Our 52 rooms offer the ultimate in comfort after a long day of sightseeing, fishing, and exploring Ketchikan. Non-anglers love Salmon Falls too. Shopping along Creek Street, kayaking, hiking, whale watching, or gathering around our fire pits with a hot beverage, all at prices less than expected. Just pull up Salmon Falls Resort in your search engine.
Welcome back to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan.
This is John Hennigan, and of course we have our host Frank Selby. This has been so much fun, Frank. It usually is.
Yeah, we usually have a really good time. You know, the neat thing about this bad epidemic is everybody is trying to go places. They're buying new bicycles. They're buying new rods. They're buying trips, renting motorhomes, and going across country. Me, it scares me a little bit, but I understand it, and I think you want to get away from everybody and the pressure on all of us. is so horrible. A day of fishing or a day being out just hiking is so relaxing and mind's settling, don't you think, John?
Frank, I think you hit it right on. After you've been in jail for 3 months or so, you just want to get the heck out.
Yeah.
And, you know, how safe is it to be out in the water on a boat? Nobody around who's copping your face. Yeah. I mean, that is fresh, pure, clean air. And how safe can it be? So get on out. Get on out there and, you know, make up for some lost time and start booking some trips in advance. Just, you know, might as well do it.
Yeah, a lot of the guides have got a lot of openings now. Usually this time of year, every guide I know is booked solid.
Yeah, there are still some for this year.
Yes, Bob is only about 50% booked of what he normally books.
Yeah.
Bob Jacklin, a bunch of the guys are got plenty of space if you want to go fly fishing or conventional
fishing. Well,
we've
still got Clover Pass in Alaska coming up in September.
Yeah, I'm hoping I'll be able to go.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, well, only time will tell.
Well, I just got to go.
Yeah.
And it's clean, it's safe, and especially Clover Pass. It's, you know, you just jump on the airplane to Seattle, and then it's 90 minutes to Clover Pass. You pick it up at the airport and take you to the lodge. All inclusive. I mean, when I say all inclusive, we're going to pay your fishing license, your bed tax, all your meals, all your fish processing, your tackle, your bait. I mean, it is all-inclusive, and it's almost free, $1,850.
Yeah, you can't beat that price.
When is that coming up? September?
September, what the heck is it? The
16th, I
23rd
saw.
To the...
Well, we'll figure it out.
19th,
I mean,
to the 23rd, I think.
Still a ways off, but people need to check in and get booked on that thing.
Yeah, there's still time.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Send me an email, john@fishtalkradio.com. By the way, Frank, anybody that sends us an email for any reason, we still got a treasure chest full of stuff.
Yeah, I only got 5 emails about what you keep in your ice chest. And
oh, is that the question?
A couple of weeks, I'm going to have somebody on to tell us exactly how many bottles of pop they sell. And maybe how many beers another company sells.
Yeah.
The winner, too, I'm going to get on the air, their production person.
Yeah.
Guys, it's time to wrap it up.
All right. Thank you, Frank. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, everybody. You know, we want to try and be entertaining, but educational.
Educational. I don't know if we're educational or not, but we're having fun anyway. This is Fish Hunt Talk Radio. John Hennigan, Frank Selby. We'll be back next week. Take care.